WPGC 95.5. What it do? Beer gang, bacon bits, beautiful people. Mm. Your girl, Poet. Yeah, that just made you hungry.
Ooh, I like
excited,
the alliteration.
And wanna,
yeah.
Hey.
Yeah.
See, already, this is about to tell you what kind of day we about to have. In the studio with me, I have the dude that Rolling Stone said was one of the top 10 artists to watch. For once, Rolling Stone did not lie to me. R.Lum.R in the building.
That is me. Thank you for having me.
Hi.
Hello.
Now, off mic, I was saying how excited I was to meet you.
Yes.
I'm having a fangirl moment.
Thank you. Thank you.
After Image, the EP that you dropped.
Yes.
Phenomenal.
Thank you. Thank you.
I feel like I'm reading your journal, though.
Yes.
I'm listening to these songs. Like, how personal did you get with this project? Because I feel like I'm, like, comment creeping in your mind.
I mean, it's made public for a reason. I mean, we were also talking off mic about you just kind of how certain stigmas are created around like mental health, and especially with like Black men and people like me. And I feel like trying to expose that and being true to your heart and like being really honest is very important. Like, I feel like you don't see that a ton, especially with someone like me who doesn't come from like the, I guess maybe the popular places and the like interesting, like cool life. And I don't do the like fast cars, drugs and money, chains kind of thing. So I don't know. I just wanted to give somebody, people, like a more unique take on what that spectrum of Blackness and like what I can be, what we all can be. You know what I'm saying? So I figured the best way I could do that was be honest. So.
Like, you, oh man, I don't know. Like, what does it feel like to be you right now? Let's say from like a year, 2 years ago. I'm big on journeys.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
A lot of people don't like really embrace the journey.
Yeah.
But I'm
yeah.
big on journeys.
Yeah, I feel the same. I agree. Like we were talking about in the car, two of my biggest, big favorite come ups. Are Gucci Mane,
yes,
and Cardi B.
We going out to dinner after this interview. We got a fellowship
because Cardi B was in the clubs like a year and a half ago or something like that. And then she's got
she was stripping when they pulled her to Love and Hip Hop.
Exactly. And then also Gucci Mane is the only rapper I can think of offhand that went to jail and actually came back rehabilitated.
Because up until that point, I thought the jail was not for rehabilitation.
Yeah.
But I also equate that to the people who are around you. I keep telling people that your friendship circle should be like your CEO. You are your business. These are your CEOs. Who's sitting at your table?
Yeah.
Because maybe having Keisha K, you ought to be like, no. When you come back, this is what we doing. And for Cardi B to have people around her that were like, eh. I grew up in foster care. So the fact that I work in a city where I was once eating out the trash cans of said city and just going through some things, I believe in the glow up and the come up.
For sure, man.
I don't want to call it the forgotten, but I kind of feel like the Cardi B's and the Gucci's are the people that people kind of threw away.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And it's amazing to watch God work these people into a place where people thought that you'd never be sitting.
Absolutely. And I remember myself being, you know what I'm saying? We slept on floors. I was homeless when I was like 16, 17, 18, you know what I'm saying? And then making it into college and then going through and continuing making more music and just keeping up and keeping up. You know what I'm saying? And I think that might be a reason why I feel like the people maybe feel so connected. Because, I mean, I still go back home, you know what I'm saying? Just like Cardi B, still being high bridge. You know
I still hang out in Baltimore and Emerson Village. Come through.
You feel me? So I think that stuff is important. Like, that honesty is important because, like, we were talking about this in the car, too. Me and my old manager, shout out Chris Martiniago, who's been my homeboy since we were 16, you know what I'm saying, for, like, 10 years or something like that now. And I remember driving up the coast. We booked those two tours for 2 months each by ourselves just through Indie on the Move or whatever we could find online, whatever phone numbers we had. Drove around his Ford Focus with no AC. You feel me? Just me and him sleeping on wood floors in Atlanta. We couldn't find a place in Indianapolis, so we slept in the Walmart parking lot and like all that stuff. And now I'm selling out places I've never been before.
Yeah.
Can we just touch upon that transition? Just for anyone watching who may feel like they don't want to get out of bed tomorrow, don't want to take the next step because they just don't think it's going to happen.
Yeah.
That's a phenomenal
story. I mean, I was very lucky. I mean, I'd be remiss to pretend like it was just like, oh, pulled myself up by my bootstraps, as those people will say, you know what I'm saying? And like that I wasn't surrounded by people who are like, no, you are more than what you have been told you are your whole life. You're more than what you like immediately think you are. Like my boy, Mikey Mejia, who was like, yeah, I mean, I know your home situation is terrible and you got to get out of there. Come stay with me. You know what I'm saying? I lived with that kid for 4 years almost all throughout my high school. You know what I'm saying? My homeboy, Chris Martiniago, who was the first person to be like, yo, no, you've got something special. And like, he was begging me back, like, went in MySpace days, yo, like, let me get your passwords. Like, let me post bulletins for you. Like, let me help you when I didn't believe in myself. You know what I'm saying? And then like, all like my first guitar teacher who was like, you're incredible. You should buy a guitar to practice on at home. But at the time, I didn't have a job and I was homeless and I was like 14, you know what I'm saying? And he didn't know the situation. He was like, okay, well, I'll waive my fee and you can take guitar lessons after school because you got something. You know what I'm saying? And so, like, it's in my, I think, in my best interest to kind of try to turn that around and say that to people that, like, yo, if it really, really, really takes a village, you feel me?
And it is important for you to know that.
Yeah, it's a big deal.
So I don't care what song you do. Suddenly Frustrated, Close Enough, probably my favorites. But I'll just sit back here, hug myself while you sing, and be excited.
Tending to be myself, and I know that I'm somewhere else. All that's left is where you are. I got a heart like a hotel, and I'm the only clientele. Trust the room, paid with my card. You come, yeah, you go. Whenever you please, whenever you need to. No, you stay, Donna, 'cause you know it's hard for me to disagree with you. Do, 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 do. I wanna let you go, but can't you? Close, I wanna quit you go, but all my thoughts, I wanna mute you loud in stereo. I need this distance to be close enough.
Yeah, it's the remix. Hey. R.Lamar, Poet up in DC. Close to you is where I want to be. Push and pull with my heart. I'ma stop Songbird tonight. Y'all want a part? Yay!